Hi, and welcome to Global Architectures with JFrog Enterprise and JFrog Mission Control webinar. I'm your host today, Mansimran Singh, Solutions Engineer at JFrog, part of the Solution Engineering team working with more than 3,500 customers, integrating artifacts into their architectures. And of course, we are here to talk about the Enterprise edition of Artifactory and Mission Control, which is part of the Enterprise pack. So, quick agenda. We will be quickly going over the JFrog platform, which consists of different JFrog products. And of course, Artifactory and Mission Control are part of that. And apart from these two products, we have X-Ray and Bintray as part of the platform. After this, we would learn how to create and manage the multi-site topologies right from the Mission Control UI. And then there's a new feature where you can integrate your GitHub account with Mission Control and you can sync your JFMC scripts so that you can easily manage these scripts right inside Mission Control. After this, the most important thing, which is a concern for all the enterprise users, is how do we manage the disaster recovery? If something goes wrong with our production cluster or with our production environment, how we can manage that, how we can leverage the features of Mission Control where we can set up a disaster recovery instance. And over here, Mission Control is a great tool to work with it. After this, we would learn about the Mission Control graphs, which is again a new feature which was added in the last two or three versions of Mission Control. And it really helps you to identify the patterns, and it really helps you in terms of predicting the storage being consumed by the different repos, by the different instances, what's the trending repository, which is the most consumed repository and all that stuff. So we would learn about the Mission Control graphs as well. And in the end, important thing, we would take up your question and answers. And I want to quickly mention over here that you can put up your questions in the Q&A tab of your Zoom window. Please don't paste that in the chat. The Q&A tab is dedicated for the questions and answers. So you can put up your questions over there and we will be taking up the questions right when the webinar gets finished. For the quality and audio purposes, all the participants would be on mute and you can anytime put up your questions, as I mentioned earlier, in the Q&A tab. If you're having any difficulties regarding the audio quality, please, you can type that to the chat window. Our coordinator will take care of it. Quickly going over the JFrog platform as part of the agenda. Now, I'm pretty sure this slide is not new to all the Artifactory users. You might have seen this platform somewhere in the conference, in the webinars, in the trainings, on our website, or anywhere else as well. So, what it basically consists of is that all the JFrog products talking to each other, but not just the JFrog products, there are industry-wide products which does talk to these four products as well. As you can see in the first step, and I would try to put up my mouse pointer so that you can easily concentrate on this diagram with a lot of other things to manage on. In the very first thing, it starts with a developer writing the new code and working on a new project. And of course, when they are writing a new code, they would be declaring the new dependencies. Right from here only, Artifactory comes into the picture. And as soon as they declare the new dependencies, basically that request comes to Artifactory in order to resolve those dependencies. Now, these dependencies could be in the form of NuGet, Ruby, RPM, Python, Maven, Docker, NPM, and a lot of others. If these dependencies are presented inside the local repository of the Artifactory, the dependencies would be resolved right away. But if the dependencies are not presented in the local repos, basically the dependency resolution would be taken care of from the remote repositories like NuGet Gallery, Maven Central, JCenter, etc., etc. Up to the third step, it's all about resolving the dependencies, and it's all about resolving the dependencies from Artifactory, apart from managing the other stuff. The developer is happy with the resolution process and he commits the changes to the VCS. And as soon as he commits the changes to the VCS, the CI server is going to trigger in, of course, by pulling methods. And here, the CI server is going to run the same build which the developer was running. And the same story happens again, that it's going to resolve the dependencies which the developer was asking. But the good news is that this time the resolution would be much, much faster because all the requested dependencies were either locally cached inside Artifactory or they were already presented inside Artifactory. So this really helps to resolve the dependencies much, much faster. And this is where Artifactory comes into the picture in order to help you up to accelerate your build processes, because everything is rightly presented over there. And this really helps you to save the time, bandwidth, resources, money, efforts, everything. And in the next step, of course, you go, when the build is ready, that would be deployed back to the Artifactory so that you don't need to go anywhere else in order to see your published modules. So two main purposes over here. One is at the time of resolution, and one is at the time of publishing of the artifacts. In both the cases, you can manage the Artifactory instances, you can manage the users, user groups, permission targets, your topologies, your replications, whatever operation you're doing with these artifacts that can be managed with the help of Mission Control, and that's what is the topic of today. Apart from that, whatever the artifacts are coming inside Artifactory, these artifacts can be scanned with the help of another product of JFrog, which is X-Ray. X-Ray is a tool which is used for scanning your artifacts in terms of discovering the security vulnerabilities and license compliance issues. And in the end, whatever you have produced, if that software is something which can be consumed inside your production servers, you can provision them with the provisioning tools like Chef, Puppet, Ansible. You can simply pick these artifacts from Artifactory with the help of the REST APIs and some other automations, and you can simply deploy these to your production servers. But if your software is something which can be consumed by external customers, is something downloadable, you can simply distribute that with the help of JFrog Pintray, which is a distribution platform running behind CDN, and your downloads for your external customers would be much, much faster because of the CDN. So this was about the platform, where we have seen that all the JFrog products are talking to each other, but apart from that, they are talking to all the industry-wide products as well. And to summarize what we saw, this is the central tool, which is Artifactory, and all the other products talking to Artifactory. We have the Mission Control to manage and control the Artifactory instances, the users, groups, permission targets, graphs, disaster recovery, and many other things, which we would be covering in the later part of the webinar. But apart from that, as we had seen that the X-Ray is also jumping in order to scan the artifacts, so you can have the security at its place. You don't need to worry about if there's any security vulnerability coming inside the organization. So this is also very, very important. And in the end, as we have mentioned earlier, that you can distribute your software with the help of Bintray as well. Going forward with Artifactory and to manage it, the Mission Control offers you a single UI to manage all the Artifactory instances. It provides your dashboard for a quick overview of whether an instance is running or not, what its state is like, what its version like, how long the license is valid for, and many other things. And with the help of the Mission Control scripts, you can simply have the automations in place to avoid all the human errors. For example, naming the repositories, naming the users. Sometimes when you're using or when you're handling this manually, you always have the typing errors and other things. But once you write down the scripts and they're tested, you can simply run these scripts over the time and you can handle this all with the help of Mission Control. And in the end, the whole purpose is to have a single pane of glass for all your instances that at any point of time, even if I have 50 instances, I can quickly go over them in just a minute and I can see what instance is having what sort of problem and is it running or not. So in order to visualize what I'm trying to convey, we'll have a demo where we'll see how to register a new instance right inside Mission Control. We'll have a quick overview of the dashboard. And then as an example, I would be creating a user on three Artifactory instances from the Mission Control, and on all the three Artifactory instances, a user would be created without going to each of them. And in the end, we would see some monitoring. What sort of monitoring does Mission Control provides you in terms of the heap usage, in terms of the RAM usage, and many other things as well. So let's jump onto the demo and see the exciting Mission Control. So here is a Mission Control. Let me modify the size. And here is the dashboard. Now on the dashboard, you can see that I'm having three Artifactory instances in all the three different locations. One is in Amsterdam, one is in Bangkok, and one is in Chicago. And the reason I have chosen these three destinations is to have an acronym that's ABC. That's A for Amsterdam, B for Bangkok, and C for Chicago, so that we can easily remember how this topology can be set up. At any point of time, on the homepage only, I can see there is a green color right to the name, right next to the name, which gives me the name of the location, the license of that particular instance, and the version of the Artifactory which is running on that particular instance. And if I want to see the tabular look, I can see out of these three instances, how many are online or how many offline right now. That's a good thing that all of three of them are running fine. And as an administrator, this is the most worrying part, that I do not have any offline Artifactory running, because that's the most central part of your DevOps cycle. Going back on the maps overview, and if I want to see some more details about any Artifactory instance, I can click on it, and it's going to give me the details like its status, its name, its URL, and its version. In the repositories tab, I can see how many repositories are there, whether they are local, remote, or the virtual ones. In the connections tab, you can see the push and the pull replications which are happening, or how an Artifactory instance is connected to other Artifactory instances. We would be doing a demo where we would be connecting these Artifactory instances with the help of a star topology, and we would be coming back on this particular tab only in order to visualize how the connections are visible to the users. In the system info, it gives you all the details about the user info, host info, Artifactory info, and you can see this is a pretty exhaustive list. So you can track each and everything of any Artifactory instance, not just the Artifactory, even the Java system info as well. And then in the next tab, I can also check what sort of license I'm having. For example, in this case, it's an enterprise license. The license hash would be given to you. It would also provide you the validity of that particular license. And if this is an HA cluster, you can see the details in the HA tab as well. In the actions tab, you have some more features. For example, if you want to refresh this particular Artifactory instance in order to see its repositories, if you want to edit this instance, and this is where you can register as well. There is an add instance button which provides the same page. If you want to edit any already registered Artifactory instance, you can click on the editor. If you want to add a new instance, you can just simply provide its name, its URL. You need to provide the authorization in terms of the username and password. If there's any proxy running, you need to provide that as well. And in the location, you can provide any location, whichever you want to specify. For example, as a matter of fact, I have provided Amsterdam, Bangkok, and Chicago. You can provide any instance wherever your Artifactory instance is running. Great, this was about the overview and adding a new instance. And now, another important thing is how I can create a new user right from Mission Control with the help of the scripts and without going to any instance individually. So I having three instances, I need to create a user on all three of them. I can check all the three checkboxes. If I need to create a user on two of them, I can simply uncheck this checkbox, and now it's going to select only in two instances. But let's take three of them. In the user info tab, I need to provide the username. Since I'm doing this webinar, I can say user webinar. I would provide the email ID as webinars@jfrog.com. The reason I'm choosing this email ID is that if you're having any questions regarding any of the webinars, or you want to inquire more about Artifactory, you can send an email to webinars@jfrog.com. The password tab, I need to provide a secure password. If you want to make this user as an admin user, you can check this checkbox. If you want to make, or if you want to disable the internal passwords and you only want to make the user to go to the encrypted passwords or the hash passwords, so you can check this checkbox. You can also check a checkbox where a user can update his profile or not. If I click the add user, if I continue, and you can see that Mission Control automatically detected that a user needs to be created on three of these instances. I can simply click on execute all. Voila. A user is created within a second on all the three Artifactory instances. And if I need to see that particular user, I need to go to the Artifactory users. Since the session got expired, I need to log in. You can see the user webinar is created, where the email ID is webinars.jfrog.com. Can update the profile and some simple other things as well. Now, this was the Chicago instance. I can go to the Bangkok instance. I again go to the users. Again, need to authenticate the session. And over here, user webinar is also created. And the third instance, which is the Amsterdam one, I again need to log in. And over here, I can go to users and create. User webinar is also being created over here. So as you can see that it took me approximately more than a minute to visit each and every instance and to go into the users tab and see that the user is created or not. But with the help of mission control, I can simply go and provide a single script and I can tell that, hey, just create this user on all the three Artifactory instances and that's it. That's the only thing you have to do. Not just creating the user, you can also edit a user, you can create a user group, you can edit a user group, you can create a new permission target and you can edit a permission target as well. So this was part of the security aspect of the mission control. There's a repo aspect as well, which we would be covering in the next demo. And now let's go back to the presentation and see what else mission control has to offer us. Now we learned that how to create a user, but what about working with the multi-sites or working with the multiple sites across the globe? We have seen on the homepage of Mission Control that we are having three Artifactory instances and they all three are running independently. But what if I want to connect them? What if I want that whatever is going in one of the instances, I want the same thing to be presented in the other Artifactory instances as well? So for this, multi-site topology comes into the picture, which ensures all the developers are using the same version of an artifact. This is one of the ways you can force the users to have the same version of the artifacts. Otherwise, every team would be using the different versions. You also ensure that all the build artifacts are shared effectively with all the global teams as well. And of course, if you have the same set of the artifacts available everywhere, it reduces the risk of the network latency and the stability of the builds. And the most important thing is that you can access any specific version on all the remote artifacts as well. So this is the graphical representation of a multi-site star topology. And as the name suggests, it's a star topology, meaning that one of the locations would be a central location and that central location would be pushing the artifacts to other sites. And this is the way it would be looking as. So again, I have taken the same example, A, B, C, D. That's Amsterdam, Bangkok, Cape Town, and Denver. So whatever is going in Amsterdam, that is multi-pushed to Bangkok, Cape Town, and Denver. And this is the way a star topology is created. And now, again, the demo time is there in order to see how this multi-site star topology can be created with the help of the mission control scripts. Great. Moving back to the demo. And now, since I was referring to the repo tab of mission control, and now is the time that I would be creating a star topology where Amsterdam would be pushing the artifacts to Bangkok and Chicago. But before that, I want to mention that right now there is no connection. As you can see on the home screen that all the three Artifactory instances are running independently. There's no connection. There's no wiring between them. But if now I want to set up a multi-site star topology, I need to check the checkboxes where I want to create them. I also have a script called as replication multi-push, which I want to push the artifacts from Amsterdam to Bangkok and Chicago. I click continue and I provide the repos to which I want to multi-push. For example, I have already created a test star multi-push Bangkok and I also have the same for the Chicago. Again, I click continue button. And again, mission control detects that I need to set up a star topology, which would be pushing the artifacts in Amsterdam, and it would be replicating the artifacts to Bangkok and Chicago. So if I click execute all, great. A repository is being created on Amsterdam, which would be pushing the artifacts to Bangkok and Chicago. And if I want to see how this would be looking in terms of the graphs, I can simply go back on the homepage, and now you can see that all the three Artifactory instances are being connected by the blue line, which shows that they all are connected. And Amsterdam is pushing the artifacts to Chicago and Bangkok. And if I want to see some more details, which I mentioned earlier, that I would be coming back on this tab. And now you can see that the Amsterdam is pushing the artifacts to Bangkok and Chicago. If I want to see some more details, since this was a multi-push, under the multi-push, the artifacts are being multi-pushed from Amsterdam Star Local to Test Star Bangkok and Test Star Chicago. And similarly, it would be visible over here as well. How easy it was to create a multi-site star topology, which would take you days to set up this kind of topology, which would be involving so many things like the network connections, other artifact tree details, the repositories, the users, and many other things. But with the help of mission control and with a single script, you can simply execute the script, not only just execution, you can visualize that process as well. And how easy is it for the administrator to monitor that my multi-push is working or not? You have all the logs where you can monitor that, whether the multi-push is working correctly or not. If I push an artifact in the Amsterdam site, that particular artifact is being replicated to the Bangkok and Chicago or not. So you have all these capabilities right inside Mission Control, not just these this UI, but you can also run this with the help of the REST APIs as well. And this is era is all about automations. Artifact Tree and Mission Control are fully REST API enabled. So you can do each and every operation, whatever I'm showing you on the UI, that can be done with the help of the REST APIs as well. Great, going back to my presentation. This was a demo of multi-site star topology. Not just the star topology, you can also set up a mesh topology as well. As you can see on your screen, that this is an example of two-site mesh topology. And as the name suggests, every site would be connected to every other site. So over here, I'm having two sites, Amsterdam and Bangkok. Amsterdam is pushing to Bangkok and Bangkok is pushing to Amsterdam, and that's the way they both are connected to each other. But what if I'm having four sites or five or six or whatever number you have? This is the way you would be having your multi-site mesh topology between four sites, Amsterdam, Bangkok, Cape Town, and Denver, ABCD. You would be having four local repos named after each location at every site. So basically Amsterdam would be having ABCD, Bangkok would be having ABCD, similarly Cape Town and Denver. Amsterdam would be pushing to Bangkok, Cape Town, and Denver. Similarly, Bangkok would be pushing to Amsterdam, Cape Town, and Denver. And this is the way all four sites would be connected to each other. So at any point of time, if I want to refer to the artifacts from every site, I can simply go inside the artifact tree. I can visit a virtual repo, which would be an aggregation of all the four sites, and I can refer to all the artifacts at any point of time I wish to. Great. We've learned a very, very important thing, how you can work collaboratively on multiple sites, how you can make your projects successful with the help of better collaboration and effectiveness with the help of mission control. And now we would learn another important aspect of enterprise editions, how we can manage the disaster recovery. And that's very important. Supposedly, if your whole data center goes down, what should be the remediation measures, where we can get the data back, how I can minimize my downtime, how I can minimize my users suffering so that they can effectively work on all their builds and they can effectively work on their projects. In order to do that, we have the capability of setting up a disaster recovery artifactory instance where you can select a master site and a target site from the artifactory instances which are registered with Mission Control. Very, very easy to set up the master and the target instance. And again, it gives you the complete graphical visualization, like how many artifactory repos are being pushed, how many are out of sync, how many are fully synced. And let me show you, in fact, how this is done. Going back to my Mission Control instance, and over here, under the monitoring tab, sorry, under the manage tab, there is a DR configuration. I would delete. And now, I would create a new disaster recovery instance. I want to select a master site and a target site, which I have the three options. I can select a master site as Amsterdam, and I can select the target site as Bangkok. I just need to click the save button and great. Within less than 10, 20 seconds, the disaster recovery is set up. And if I click on it, it shows me that both the instances are online. And if I click on the repos, you can see that how many repos are fully synced, how many are out of sync, and how many are missing repos. Right now, all the repos are missing from the master site to the target site. The reason being, I have not initiated the disaster recovery. As soon as I click this button, it's going to replicate each and every artifactory repo, each and every user, each and every configuration onto the target side. And you can monitor each and everything right inside the logs over here. If anything goes wrong, it would update you that the master is not able to set up the target fully synced to each other. And that's the way you can set up your disaster recovery instance. As soon as anything is pushed inside the master side, since it's even based, so your artifacts will be replicated to the target side at that very moment only. Not just this, if due to any reason it's being missed, the scheduled replication would take care of the missing artifacts as well. Such easy is to manage your disaster recovery instance. I myself have set up disaster recovery instances long back when Mission Control was not there. And it really takes some time to set up the disaster recovery instance. I need to take care of the storage. I need to take care of the database. I need to take care of the artifactory instances. I need to monitor both of them. And that was a very painstaking process. But with the help of Mission Control, this became very, very easy. And as you can see on the screen, it was hardly a process of 10, 20 seconds. You would just select two checkboxes and there you go. Mission Control would take care of each and everything. With the introduction of this feature, most of our enterprise customers, they felt so happy that every time they said that this was the most painstaking process of setting up a disaster recovery and the most required feature as well. So that's the way Mission Control helps you to set up the disaster recovery instance. Going back. And the last part of this webinar, that is graphs. I talked about this in the agenda that the graphs gives you some visualization of the storage of top five artifactory instances which are consuming the most storage, top five the repos in terms of their consumption, and the top five repositories in terms of the storage as well. So let me show you the Mission Control graphs. For this, I would be referring to this particular Mission Control instance, which is having some data inside it. So as you can see on the screen that I'm having two artifactory instances, which is registered with this particular instance. And let me modify the size as well so you can see each and everything clearly. So over here, I can see there is a dot which gives me that in Feb 2017, 61.05 GB of consumption was there. If I want to talk about the top five repos, I can see that in the week of March 15 to 21st, that was the last week, Artifactory US5 Docker Local 2 was consuming 6.56 GB. And this week, this trend has changed. You can clearly see that last week, this particular repo was consuming 52 gigabytes. And over here, the same repo is there, which is consuming as well. But there are four repos which were consuming this much size, and this time it's only two repos. So I can, just with the naked eye, I can see that two repos are there which were consuming almost more than 50 gigs last week, and they are not consuming the size this week. So as a measure, I can quickly check that what's wrong, that somebody accidentally deleted the repos or somebody deleted the artifacts. So it gives me a very, very clear representation that what all is going on with the repos. And not just the repos, you can quickly get a glance of the artifactory instances as well. For example, Artifactory 5, US5 is having this much consumption, Artifactory US4 is having this much consumption, and they have 93% of the space allocated them as free. If this value would be reaching near to it, it's going to give you that, hey, it's nearing 90% or 80%, you need to take some action and you need to provide some more storage, you want to provide some more volume mount points, and this is the way you can track the graphs over here. In the top five repos, you can select the instance, and based from that particular instance, it's going to provide you the top five repos of that particular instance. Sorry for that. And from the Artifactory 5, you can see the top five repos. This is the one which is having 52.02 of the consumption. This is having 6.56, and this is having 1.49. And if I go to 4, this would be having some other numbers. So as you can see, these are presented to me right away. So graphs provide you some predictive mechanism where you can simply visit a page and you can predict that what is going on with all my instances, what is going wrong with all my repos, what is the storage which the each artifactory individually is consuming, what is the storage which each and every repo is also consuming in per artifactory instance. I touched all the aspects of the mission control, but there's another aspect of the mission control that's a monitoring, and I can monitor each and every artifact tree since this is a HA of artifact tree, meaning that the two nodes are running behind in a cluster. This is an active-active cluster, meaning that if one of the node goes down, your other artifact tree node would be up and there would be no downtime and your users and build processes won't be impacted in any way. And if I go into this particular artifact tree instance, I click on the monitoring tab, I click on the Amsterdam. It's going to provide me some general information, as I mentioned earlier, that what's the heap memory usage is, what's the CPU usage is, what's the machine CPU parameters are, what's the swap memory usage, threads to CPU ratio. And if this is near its threshold value, it's going to alert you with the help of the red colored thing that, hey, this is near its threshold value, you need to take care of something. In the storage summary, it's going to give you the details about the binaries count, the binary size, artifact size, optimizations achieved, item count, artifact count, the total space allocated weight, what is the use space, and what is the free space as well. In the replication, it's going to give you the details about the replications which are happening. Since we had set up a start topology replication, I can see when was the last time it was executed, which is the source artifact tree, which is the destination artifact tree. This has never been executed because I never clicked the initiation button. If it has been executed, it would show you when was the last time it was executed, how long did it took, and when the next time it's going to execute as well. In the task summary, it's going to list down all the tasks which are running behind the scenes, all the cron job tasks, for example, your build cleanups, your artifacts cleanup, your garbage collection, your binary stored garbage collection, and all the other things which are scheduled. It would also provide you some details about these jobs as well. For example, you can see that artifact version checker, artifact files indexer, download statistics, extra indexing events, all these events would be noted over here as well. And if you want to write the new scripts inside Mission Control, there's this button, which provides you the options where you can write down the scripts. For example, for writing down the user groups, users, proxy, version control, mail configuration, any notifications. So you can write down each and everything over here. And in the repo tab, I have already written 10 scripts. For example, I have executed this script, which was replication multi-push, which was used to set up a multi-site start topology, where I'm providing from the UI, the user put as name of the repo and the type. And then it's going to replicate that particular artifact tree repo to the ones which I checked from the UI. And then you provide the cron job expression, when is the scheduled replication taking place, username, the password, the event based replication is true or false. You want to sync the deletes, you want to sync the properties, each and everything is given over here. Similarly, you can write down the other scripts as well. If you want some help writing down these scripts, if you want some learning, you can go to github.com/jfrogtraining. I can show you that page as well. So this is a page where you can have the demo scripts from us. We always write down the demo script from time to time in order to help the users to learn more about these products. Under this, you have the folder called as JFMC, that's JFrog Mission Control. Under JFrog Mission Control, there's a repository tab, which is having all these 10 or 12 scripts, which are being written in order to help you up, in order to learn how you can set up the repos, how you can set up the replications, how you can create the local, remote, and the virtual repos. Not just this, you can get some other features over here as well. For example, you can get the Java 8 installation document, JFMC pull command, new user creation script, new repo creation script, the start topology replication script, and some commands list as well. So that's a way you can learn more about Mission Control. And not just Mission Control, as I mentioned earlier, we provide some learning scripts for Docker, Git LFS, some advanced automations as well, some artifact tree scripts as well, and then some user plugin dev environments. All these things are provided right on this particular page. Going back, this was Mission Control, showing you how the artifact instances are connected to each other. And I want to quickly announce our most happening user conference. So JFrog Swamp Up is coming in May. That's 24th to 26th of May, happening in Napa Valley. Tickets are available. I've never seen anybody who has visited this conference and they never want to come back. Great people, great technologies, great speakers, great environment, and a great place to visit as well. Also want to mention our keynote speakers. as you can see, people from CloudBees, Google, and of course, JFrog co-founders, the vision behind JFrog products, they would be speaking over there as well, sharing their vision, which when they design JFrog and JFrog products, and everything which is there in our roadmap. And now is time for your questions. So I've got one question from one of our users that how mission control can help me in terms of setting up these topologies. So this was the main topic of this webinar as well, to set up the topologies. And the example which I took during this webinar was setting up a multi-site star topology. But apart from that, you can set up any topology you want. For example, you're having five artifactory instances and you want to connect three of them with the help of a mesh topology and two of them with some star topology. So you can have a mixture of topologies as well. You can have hybrid topologies as well. And for this, you have the scripts, but you can also design this with the help of the UI. And whatever you would be doing on the artifactory side, the same thing would be shown on the mission control side as well. So both the products are talking to each other with the help of the heartbeat signals. At any point of time, if one of the artifactories are not running and they are offline, mission control is going to immediately show you that on the homepage that this particular artifactory instance is not running. And that's a way you can immediately monitor all your global artifactory instances. And that's a way you can secure all your globally presented artifacts as well. Another question which is coming up is that how you can design some more scripts apart from the one which we have provided over there. So writing the new scripts is a very, very easy thing to do. Only a few lines are required in order to set up a script. And when you would be starting using these scripts, you can also visit our wiki.jfrog.com. That's a wiki page for Artifactory. And similarly, the links are provided for the other products as well. And over there, only the mission control link is also provided, which gives you the detailed documentation on how to write down the scripts, how you can leverage the other features, how you can set up the disaster recovery. And from time to time, we also do these webinars where we show the users on how you can use these products and how you can make better use or the advanced use of these products as well, according to what we provide and according to what other customers provide as well. If you're not having any more questions for us, here's the time to finish off this webinar. Thank you for participating and thank you for providing the feedback. Thank you for your questions as well. We will see you in the future webinars, which would happen from time to time. Thank you and see you at SwampUp.